Good morning, everybody. Good morning, UK. Thank you for joining in. What city, what state, what country are you joining in from? You know it. We're family all around the world. Come on, check in all around the world. New Mexico, I see you. Good morning, Fort Worth, we see you. Let me see. Detroit, I see you. Let's see, L-E-D-I-S-I. If you don't mind. Stockton, California, we see you. God bless you. Raleigh, North Carolina, God bless you. Chester, Virginia, we see you. God bless you. So I turn a fan off above me. Baton Rouge, Louisiana, God bless you. We see you. Thank you for joining in this morning. Dayton, Ohio, God bless you. Orlando, Florida, we see you. God bless you. God bless you all around the world. Michigan, we see you. God bless you. Thank you for joining in this morning. Kennesaw, Georgia, God bless you. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, we see you. God bless you. Irving, Texas, God bless you for joining in. Michigan, Greensboro, I believe that's North Carolina. Cincinnati, Ohio, we see you. Austin, Texas, we thank you for checking in. Irving, Texas, we see you. God bless you. Austin, Texas. Oh, my God. We thank God for everyone all around the world. Yes, don't forget to share. Don't forget to invite. God said it because I said so. Oh, my God. My God. New Rochelle, New York, I believe that is. Summersville, South Carolina, Mississippi has just joined us. Kansas City, Missouri, God bless you. We thank God for you. Yes. Cypress, Texas, we see you. Amen. Thank you, Prophetess. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for getting that information to everyone. Amen. That's right. Let them know that it was not me. Amen. Minneapolis, Minnesota, we see you. Thank you for joining in. Thank you for connecting. This is the Weather Forecast Channel, and it's time to know what is happening in the atmosphere of your life in the realm of the spirit. Fayetteville, North Carolina, God bless you. Robert Durnham, thank you for joining in with us today. Las Vegas, we see you. God bless you. What city? South Bend, Indiana, we see you. Kankakee, Illinois, God bless you. Thank you for checking in. There is a word. Thank you for the hearts. Thank you for the thumbs up. Thank you so much. Yes. It is the music. Her name is L-E-D-I-S-I. If you don't mind. L-E-D-I-S-I. That's her name. If you don't mind. East St. Louis, God bless you. Blessings to everyone. In about 60 seconds, we're going in. That's it. That's it right there. Yes, that's how you spell it. If you don't mind, it's the name of the song. That's it. That's how you spell her name. Yes. Yes. Oh. Blessings to God be all the glory. And I pray that the Lord spoke something through me to you, Shannon. Man. In about 10 seconds, we're going in. Yes, we are. Yes, we're going in about 10 seconds. Have you joined in? What city, what state, what country are you joining in from? We thank God for you, 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 and you. For we are all around the world. And we thank God for what he is doing. Amen. Yes, we thank God for what he is doing with us and for us. Yes, 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 yes. Thank you again for the thumbs up and thank you for the hearts. We appreciate it all. We thank you for praying with us. We thank you for standing with us. Amen. Cleveland, Ohio has just checked in. We thank God for you. Noonan, Georgia, we see you. Thank you for joining. Oklahoma City, God bless you. Bronx, New York just joined in. God bless you. God bless you, Gail. We thank you for joining in. Blessings, Victoria. I see you. The title of the song, and if you don't mind, her name is L-E-D-I-S-I. L-E-D-I-S-I. Springs, Maryland, I believe that was. God bless you, Union City, Georgia. We thank God for you. It was so hard to see. Yes. Gainesville, Florida, we see you. God bless you. Thank you for joining in with us. Spring, Texas. God bless you. Pastor Loretta Guillory, daughter, how are you? Albany, New York, we see you. Thank you for joining in. Amen. Yes. To God be the glory. I see it. I receive it. Mobile, Alabama, we see you, and we love you too, Veronica. Thank you for joining in this morning. We're going in a second. There it is. That's it, divine favor. That's it. That's it. That's it right there. Yes. If you don't mind. See, I know where I'm going if you don't mind. Come on. Praise the Lord, everybody. We thank God for you, 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 and you. And to those that will be joining in, amen, after the fact, amen, when we go off of Facebook Live, being live, they still will come in and begin, excuse me, and begin to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Well, this is your Weather Forecast channel, and everybody knows me. I am your Weather Forecast announcer for the Rim of the Spirit. In other words, even though there's something going on in your life in the natural realm, glory to God, that is not the same thing that's going on in the realm of the spirit. And so the Lord has unctioned me and assigned me to come on every Wednesday until he releases me to come on every Wednesday around about 6 a.m. And to thank God, Jamaica has just joined in. God bless you. Glory to God, to come on every Wednesday around about 6 a.m. and bring forth the weather forecast. And this is the Weather Forecast channel. And I thank God for you, 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 and you. Everybody knows that we are family all around the world. We thank God because God is doing a great work with all of us. And we have joined in as a family to encourage one another, to build one another up. Glory to God, and to pray for one another and let each other know that we're not in this all by ourselves. And so we are excited on today. This is the last Tuesday of the first month of 2018. And though I'm excited for all that is happening in the month of January, you have to understand, to you, 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 and you, if you have not done your first fruits unto your house, to your man or to your woman of God, you need to do so. And to you all that has no ministry, no church home, you need to make sure you get your first fruits in. There is a teaching on first fruits, which is called the overwhelming blessing. You need to find yourself to go to that clip and hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying and how God is breaking down and teaching us about first fruits. You need to understand that when the matrix, the first month, and this is free, the first month, everything that is happening in the first month is setting the tone for the rest of the year. Y'all not saying nothing to me. So just because a great hit came, it didn't knock you back. That great hit had a force behind it. And that great force that came to hit you, may a glory to God, is going to cause you to finish, amen, out strong. Y'all not saying nothing. And so you should not have your head down. You should not be saying, oh my God, this is the first of the month, and then what's going to happen in February? Nope, the first of the month is telling you, glory to God, if you got hit fast, come on here, there's something God is going to do for you, and you need to understand what first fruits mean. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? And so I say to you, if you have not done so, amen, make your way to your woman and man of God and give that first fruits. Is anybody listening? Yes. Glory to God. Oh my God, I am excited of what God is saying and what God is doing. And again, welcome to everyone around the world, amen, that have stopped by for such a time as this to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. Yes. God said, because I said it. Or you can say it like this: God said it because I said so. Oh, woo, glory to God. So you can pick whichever way you want to say it. God said, because I said it, or because I said so. Look at y'all looking at me. We might as well go ahead and practice that real quick. I don't care if you don't have nobody around. Y'all know how we do it. Amen. You are your neighbor, and you need to tap your own self and say, because, amen, because God said it, because, watch this, I said it, or because I said so. Look at y'all looking at me. We thank God for Chicago Heights just joining in. See, baby, you don't know the God that I serve. See, that's the way you need to be acting. You need to be telling the enemy, you don't even know the God I serve. You don't even know that when he says something, he's going to bring it to pass. God, look at y'all. Yes, Holy Spirit, I hear you. The enemy wants to bring up your flaws. The enemy wants to bring up, amen, all the things that we have done. done wrong. But God said, let me help you with something. Before they were formed in their mother's womb, I already knew who they were. I already knew what type of mistakes they was going to make. But one thing I know, glory to God, they would have stood on my word. And because I said so, oh my God, it's going to come to pass. And that's why I'm about to get up and do my dance. Because God said so. Because God said it, it has to happen. He didn't say it because I was perfect. He didn't say it because I had everything all together. Somebody better talk to a sister up in here. He didn't say it because I had all my T's crossed, all my D's, my I's dotted, all the commas in the right places. Y'all not saying nothing. The capitalizations of the words in the right place. Y'all not saying nothing. He said it because he wanted to say it. Look at y'all looking at me. I feel like dancing. Yes, Lord. The devil thought he was doing something, amen, to hit me when I got up yesterday morning. But God said, I said a word. There's a word over her life. And my God, from Zion, where the enemy hits you is where God spoke the word. And when God speaks a word over your life, that is the very thing that shall come to pass. I'm trying to encourage about three people, and I know that it's more than three people on this weather forecast channel on this morning. God said, because I said it, or you can say it like this, because I said so. I need a greeter. Right there. Come on here, somebody. Tell your neighbor, amen. Scoot over. The blessings of the Lord make it rich and it add no sorrow. Tell your neighbor, scoot over. My healing is coming because God want to heal me. Tell your neighbor to scoot over. God want to bless me because he want to bless me. Oh, here we go. My God, from Zion, I'm getting ready to dance. If you don't see me, amen, I got to go and do my dance. You got to learn how to praise God. There's a lot of people in it, and even the enemy that does not like you, because God wants to bless you. My God, from Zion, if they followed you home and see that you are in need of a blessing, they wouldn't trip on you like they've been tripping. But because God said it, and because God said so, he is going to do it. Somebody to clap your hands and say, hey! Hey. If you don't mind, glory to God. Oh, you don't understand. Glory to God. You mean to tell me God gonna do this for you? You mean to tell me God gonna open a door? You mean to tell me God is going to remove, amen, that very thing that was sticking in your way all this time? You got to turn around and tell people God said it. Glory to God, because he want to do it. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Y'all know I'm a word girl. Don't play with a sister. I'm gonna back it up in the word. But before I back it up in the word, you better start praising God. Before I back it up in the word, you better give God some glory. Before I back it up in the word, you better tell the Lord thank you. Because you don't understand. It wasn't because we had everything and we did everything right. I don't care what you drive. I don't care where you live. I don't care how you dress. I don't care what type of wig you wear. What type of a weed you weave. I don't care what type of tie you wear. I don't care what type of snakeskin shoes you wear. Alligator, whatever other alligator. Come on here, somebody. It's not because of that. It is because when God says it, it is because he wants to do it. Y'all not saying nothing. That's why we all should be praising God right now. Because when we look back over our life, and there's things that God blessed us with that we know we didn't even deserve it. But because he said, he's so Messiah. Because he said, I want to do it. And because I want to do it, I got to speak a word in your life. Look at y'all looking at me. Y'all, some of us were sitting right in the dung hung or in the dung hill. And here come God said, I'm going to bring you up. And I'm going to bring you out, and I'm going to sit you on high. Look at y'all looking at me, and you looking at your surroundings saying, what? And God said, I said it because I want to say it, and because I said it, I'm going to do it. Yes. It wasn't because you all that. I'm trying to help somebody. You better tell your neighbor, it's not because I'm all that. It's because God said so. I got to calm down, because if I don't, I heard the Holy Ghost said if they gonna get mad, let them get mad. But this is the reason why I'm going to bless you in 2018. Because I said so. Because I said it. Look at y'all looking at me. God said to tell the people, and he gave me this word. My God, this very word, amen, for the Weather Forecast Channel on today. He gave me this word a couple of days ago, and I wrote it down, and I just started chuckling in my spirit. He said, you go and tell them on Wednesday, because I said it. I said, what you say? He said, you go and tell them because I said it.
Yes!
Tell your neighbor, glory to God, you may not trust my word, but you better trust what God said. You may not trust your boss word, but you better trust what God said. You may not trust, amen, your utility bills and all them saying that they gonna work with you, but you better trust what God said. He told me to tell us, come on here Wednesday on the Weather Forecast Channel, and to say, God said because I said it. And if you want to change it and say, because God said so. You got to understand, God said, I'm going to back my word up. When I tell you I'm going to bring you out, I'm going to back my word out. When I tell you I'm getting ready to deliver, I'm going to back my word up. When I tell you I'm going to bring your children back together again, I'm going to back my word up. When I tell you I'm going to give you the promotion, I'm going to back my word up. When I tell you that I'm going to heal your body, I'm going to back my word up. Somebody better clap your hands and say, yeah. So come on, y'all know how it is. My bad, she called you. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. He said, tell them because I said it. He said, go and tell my people because I said it. Glory to God, my God from Zion. Oh, somebody better know what God is saying today. Glory to God. You mean to tell me God gonna do that for you? Listen, that's what he said. And because he said it, I believe it. He said, go and tell them I said it. And because I said it, I'm going to back up every word that I said. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, watch what God do in the next couple of days of my life. Y'all not saying nothing. I gotta calm down over here. God said, because I said it. And if you want to say it like this, because I said so. You all and myself that have children, and we tell our children to do something, and then, you know, well, I got one because, you know, he is an apostle, and he be acting like, but he don't even know it. Amen. And I tell him to do something, and he got to come back and say, why? Or, you know, I'm going to do this, or I want you to do this, and he'll come back and say, why? And I'll turn around and say, because I said so. Y'all not saying nothing. Y'all ought to be, look, somebody should have been clapping their hands. Glory to God, because he minister, you taught kids. And you, when you tell them to do something, and they say, why do I got to do this, and why do I got to do that? And then you wait till you turn it around and say, because I said so.
You
because I said so, you got to do what I said. Like I said, y'all not saying nothing. That's why you need to praise God. Because God said, because I said so. And because God said so, he has to do what he said. Are y'all getting this? Some of y'all got children, you ought to be shouting. You got some children, you can listen. You got to sit here and explain. I ain't got to explain. It's because I said so. And so the Lord said, you don't have to explain the next move of God in your life. Hey, y'all not saying nothing. I said, God said, you don't have to explain to nobody the next move of God in your life. In other words, you don't have to explain why God did what he did for you. Because God said, whatever I say that I'm going to do, I'm going to back up. And you don't have to explain yourself to nobody. You don't have to sit here and say, well, I had everything all together, because you know you didn't. Look at y'all looking at me. You don't have to explain yourself for the next move of God in your life. Nobody has said nothing to me, God. I said, you will not have to explain the next move of God in your life. Somebody better get ready. Get ready, because you will not have to explain this next move, because God said, tell them because I said it, and because I said it, I got to do it. Look at y'all looking at me.
Yes. Come on,
Oh, let me get come some word here. Up in this place.
Come on here, Pastor.
The Holy Ghost said, if you're a man, if you're a woman, then you say whatever it is. And you say, glory to God. Glory to God. You begin to say to them, because you're a man or a woman, respond, I'm his girl.
I'm his girl.
If you're a man, you say I'm his boy. If you're a woman, you say I'm his girl. Come on, I gotta explain this next move. I'm trying to help y'all, because you're going to sit there and try to explain, glory to God, why you got increase on your money. So y'all messing with me, and I'm going to have to go ahead and tell y'all something in the Holy Ghost. You ain't got to explain, glory to God, my God, why you getting another promotion. You ain't got to explain, amen, why they came to you and opened up the door when there was other people. You don't have to explain, glory to God, that you got the land, amen, for little or nothing. You don't have to explain, glory to God, that my God, the car dealer made a mistake and they're going to bring your car back and they're going to repay you. You don't have to, y'all not saying that. You don't have to explain, glory to God, that they're getting ready to give you more hours, amen, and get ready to take from somebody else. Y'all not saying nothing. You don't have to explain. All you got to do is be a chest of cheese and cheese your way and say, thanks be unto God whom gives us the victory, because God said it. Y'all not saying nothing to a sister. I just need you to say this one more good time. I will not have to explain this next move of God.
I will not have to explain this next move of God.
Glory to God. Because if you're in the realm of the spirit and God has allowed you to connect with people in the realm of the spirit, there are some people, according to scripture, the Bible says, eye, have not seen, ear, ear, has not heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man what the Lord has purposed for them whom he's loved. Then you go to the next scripture, but he said, to them that is in the spirit, they shall know, I shall reveal to them what I'm going to do. So those that did not see what God was going to do by the way of the Spirit, look at y'all looking at me. You should have paid close attention. You was paying close attention to my flesh. You was paying close attention, glory to God, to my weakness. You was paying close attention of what you thought that was not mounting to anything. But when you should have been looking in the realm of the Spirit, that was where God was moving. That was where God was working. That was where God was, my God, dealing with me. And now I'm not going to have to explain this next move. I just heard the Holy Ghost say, somebody get ready to say, I didn't see it coming. It won't be you, but it will be them. They didn't see this coming. They didn't see the promotion coming. They didn't see. Y'all not saying nothing to me. You got to understand, God said, tell them because I said it. Or other words, because I said so. And for leaders that's on here, you ought to be shouting right now, because you're not going to have to explain this next move. Come on here. Tell your neighbor, glory to God. All of a sudden, where things was not prospering, now things are getting ready overnight begin to prosper. Y'all not saying nothing. I'm getting ready to go to the word. Glory to God. Where there was no, amen, manifestation, where there was no mobility, glory to God, is about to be some mobility. And my God, from Zion, God said, I'm getting ready to speed up time for you. Glory to God. Y'all not saying nothing. Hey. Here come Joel. Glory to God. I shall restore the years unto you. Tell your neighbor there's a restoration coming. And when there's a restoration coming unto thee, said the Lord, I got to speed up time. I got to give you back pay at the same time I give you a present day pay. Y'all not saying nothing. Say that again, girl. I sure will. God said at the same time that I give you a present pay, P-A-Y, I got to give you back pay. Y'all not saying that. I guess I'll say it again. God said at the same time that I give you a present today payment, I gotta give you back pay at the same time. Tell your neighbor to get ready, because it's going to overtake you.
My God, watch this.
The Bible says, according to the book of Deuteronomy, and the blessings of the Lord will overtake you. Y'all not saying nothing. For something to overtake you mean it's going to do what? Run you down.
You best come on, mother.
Is anybody listening? You ain't going to have to explain this next move of God. Go to the book of Isaiah. Because I told you, I had to back up right there. Because I was getting ready to jump up and start praising God. You understand what I'm saying? Did y'all hear me? Let me prophesy again, because maybe y'all didn't get that. Glory to God. There's a payday today. But God said, at the same time that I'm paying you today, I'm going to give you back pay at the same time. Y'all not saying nothing. That's why you're going to look at the check and say, did they make a mistake? And God said, no, they ain't make no mistake, because I told you. I told you I was going to pay you and at the same time give you back pay. Now, it may not be no money, but God said, I'm going to pay you and give you back pay, which means what you should have got yesterday, you're going to get it today as well as getting what I have purpose for you to get. Somebody ought to clap their hands. And yes, somebody ought to receive that. You, and somebody should be saying thank you. Because God said, I'm getting ready to cause the blessings of the Lord to overtake you. Yes, I'm getting ready to cause the blessings of the Lord to run you down. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor the blessings are looking for you. And now I'm on a football field. I'm on a football field and the blessings is looking for me. Y'all not saying nothing. Glory to God, and it's taking off and it's running behind me and it's about to overtake me. Tell your neighbor, get ready, because God said, because I said it, because I want to do it, says God. And glory to God, tell your neighbor, but they're going to say this. Watch what your neighbors say. But I thought you was going through so bad yesterday. But the Lord stepped in your spirit on today and said, that was then and this is now. Tell your neighbor, I was going through then, but now God has blessed me. God has overthrown the work of the enemy. Y'all not sick. And what was not being produced in my life is now being produced. I decree and declare that the spirit of producing has hit your belly. Oh Zion, glory to God, the spirit of producing has hit your belly. Tell your neighbor, I'm about to produce now. I'm about to I'm about to have the manifestation. I need somebody to receive that. I need somebody to conceive that. I need somebody to birth that out in their spirit, says God. Clap your hands and say yes. Go to Isaiah. Go to Isaiah chapter 48. Are y'all ready?
Yes, Mama.
That's right, Deborah Brown, payday and back pay at the same time. That's glory to God, payday, amen. And back pay at the same time. Glory to God, look at y'all looking at me. I said payday and back pay at the same time. God is about to overwhelm you, amen. Because why is God about to overwhelm you? Because he what? He said it. And if you want to say it like this, because he said so. Come on here. Glory to God. Who am I to ask God, why are you blessing me? Who am I to ask God, why you open up this door? Who am I to ask God, God, why are you doing this? No, I'm not going to ask him. I'm just going to receive. Yeah. I'm just going to bless him. I'm just going to thank him. Why? Because he wanted to do it. And because he wanted to do it, how dare me ask him, why is he doing it?
Come on, mother. Come on.
Oh, yes, Lord. Isaiah 48 is where we're going.
Yes.
Isaiah 48.
We sure enough looking at you.
Let's go. Isaiah 48, verse 11. The Bible decrees the word of God to be so. Here we go. For mine own sake. Can I shut the Bible right there? For mine own sake.
Stop right there.
This is Isaiah 48 and verse 11. For mine own sake. Come
that,
on here.
That right by itself is good.
For my own
you
sake.
You ain't gotta go no further.
For my own sake. Even for my own sake. What God does, he repeats himself. And anytime God repeats himself, amen, it's glory to God, you have to understand, not only is it established, but it's about to happen quickly.
Yes,
he said, for my own sake. Then he repeats himself and say, for my own sake. In other words, listen at what I'm telling you. For my own sake. Glory to God, I'm going to do it. It's for my own sake. It ain't got nothing to do with you.
Okay.
I'm getting ready to dance. It ain't got nothing to do with me. It's all got to do with him for mine own sake. Then he repeats himself. And somebody said they dropped the mic. Girl, I know.
I know.
Drop the mic and start dancing. He said, for mine own sake. And then he repeats himself, because maybe you didn't hear him the first time. He said, I'm not playing with y'all. This is for my own sake. Glory to God. Watch this. For my own sake, even for my own sake, will I do it? Y'all done got quiet on the sister.
We think.
For my own sake, for my own sake. He said, will I do it? I'm doing this for my own sake. Y'all not saying nothing.
Go ahead, brother.
And because God gonna do it for his own sake, now you know God got to go up and beyond. He's going to go up and beyond. Yes. Amen. Because whatsoever man think, he has to go up and beyond. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
he said,
brother.
Tell them I'm doing this for my own sake.
Yes.
I will do it for my own sake.
Yes.
Y'all not saying
yes,
nothing.
Mother.
For how should my name be polluted?
How?
And I will not give my glory to another. I'm getting ready.
You about to come on, mother.
He said, how will my name be polluted? In other words, the enemy, glory to God, is literally saying, y'all ain't coming out of this.
Come on.
He can't get y'all out of this.
Apostle.
Father!
He can't give y'all the breakthrough.
Mother!
It still ain't got nothing to do with us.
It ain't got nothing to do with us.
The enemy is talking about God.
Ooh.
And saying God can't do it.
Right.
And God is saying, hold up.
Ooh.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
My name will not be polluted.
We'll
I know they're going through.
Come on here.
But I need to use them right now. Because I'm getting ready to do it. Come on. But because I don't want my name being polluted. In other words, we're calling on the name of the Lord. And saying, Lord, help us. And saying, Lord, deliver us. And Lord, save us. And Lord, heal us. And Lord, make a way. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
so we are speaking in his name. And so therefore, if God don't do it, come on somebody, then we are polluting his name. Because why? We are going through. Why? Because there's something about us that we have weakness in us. And so God said, I got to do it because my name is not going to be polluted.
Come on here, mother.
In other words, I need people to trust my name. Oh, I'm gone.
Father.
And if I don't do it, they won't trust my name.
Ooh.
Y'all not saying nothing.
Ooh.
God said, if I don't do it, they won't trust my name. Because my name cannot be polluted.
Come on here, mother.
Come on. Because a lot of us know that our name, that's why you got to have a good name. That's why God got to clean us up. And that's why God got to purge and purify us. Because he's trying to give us a good name. And it's not our good name, Vanessa. It's our good name, God. That is in us. Are you hearing me? So he said, for my own sake, for my own sake will I do this. Because my name cannot be polluted. And I'm not giving my glory to another.
Jesus.
Somebody said, Sally said, I'm on the floor. Girl, I'm right there with you. In other words, if God don't deliver, if God don't heal, if God don't make a way, y'all not saying nothing, then the glory is going to that situation that the enemy has conjured up and watch this and put it into our life. God said, I'm not giving my glory. I'm not giving my glory to doom. I'm not giving my glory. Y'all not saying nothing. I'm not giving my glory to defeat. I'm not giving my glory to sickness. I'm not giving my glory to poverty. I'm not giving my glory to division and discord. I'm not giving my glory, come on somebody, to pride. I'm not giving my glory. Y'all not saying nothing to me. I'm not giving my glory to self-righteousness. Maybe I'm hollering too loud, John. Am I hollering too loud?
No. No.
God said I'm not going to give my glory to defeat. Did y'all hear that? God said, I'm not giving my glory to defeat. Because if God don't do it, then defeat will get the glory. If God don't do it, then sickness will get the glory. If God don't do it, then poverty will get the glory. If God don't do it, then doubt will get the glory. Shall I go on? Shall I go on? Amen. Now you fill in the blank. Everything that is negative, if God don't do it, then debt, D-E-B-T, will get the glory. My God. My God. And he said, I can't. He said, I will not allow my name to be polluted, and I will not give my glory to another. That's what he mean. Okay. Y'all okay? Are y'all okay? He said, I'm not giving my glory, amen, to defeat. I'm not giving my glory to depression. I'm not giving my glory to death. I'm not giving my glory. Come on here. You want me to go scripture? All right, here we go. Moses is now with the children of Israel, and they murmuring and complaining like they always do. And God said, you know what? I'm getting ready to wipe them out because they don't trust that I'm God. They don't trust in my name. They don't trust in what I said that I can do. And then here come Moses, amen, talking to God and said, God, think about this thing. If you wipe them out, then your enemies that who don't like you, come on here. They gonna say you don't have the ability, you don't have the power, and you don't have the authority to bring them out. He said, think about what you're about to do. That's scripture. Moses is talking to God and said, think about this, because if you wipe out, amen, whom you have chosen to bless and they don't even trust you, if you wipe them out, glory to God, you brought them out of Egypt, they're in the wilderness and they murmur and complain. If you wipe them out in the wilderness, then your enemies are going to say that you didn't have the power to bring them into a promised land that you told them you promised to them. Is anybody listening? My God from Zion. And so God said, all right, this is what I'm going to do. Glory to God. I'm going to raise up another generation.
Yes.
And I'm going to allow this generation to be died off.
Yes.
Because they don't trust my name. They don't believe me. Come on here, somebody. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, God said, because he said it. Don't you know, according to Isaiah 48, verse 11, glory to God, did I hit 15 yet? No, I didn't even hit 15. I'm still on verse 11. You got to understand, he said, for my name's sake, baby, my name won't be polluted. Because you got to trust in my name. So if I don't do it, if I don't just come on in your life and do something to blow your enemy's mind and my enemy's mind, come on here, then you won't trust my name no more. And when I tell you, said the Lord, to go and witness about my name, glory to God, you can't witness about my name because there's no trust behind my name. That's why he got to do it.
Wow.
That's why he got to do it. He said, because my name will not be polluted, and I'm not giving my glory to another. And that does not mean you sitting over here, hallelujah. No, he said, what you going through? If I don't bring you out, then that very circumstance will get the glory. Whatever is doing to you now, if I don't bring you out, say the Lord, it's getting the glory. Are y'all getting it?
Yes, mother.
Are you getting it?
Yes.
So he has to do it, because if not, then that circumstance will get the glory.
Come on, mother. Come on.
Tell your neighbor, I take that to the bank and cash it.
Come on here.
Go to verse 15. Watch what he says. He said, I have spoken, yea, I have called him. I have brought him, and he shall make his way prosperous. God said, I called it. It ain't said I, even them. He said, me, God, said it. Come on, I called. Which means when he called, he did what? He spoke. When he spoke it, he said, your way is going to be prosperous. He said, because I said it. Y'all not saying nothing.
Yes, mother.
Because I said it. Well, what you do so good that God is doing this for you? Boom. I ain't doing nothing so good. He's doing it because he want to do it.
Come on, mother.
For my own sake.
Come on here.
For my own sake, he repeated himself.
Yes.
Will I do it?
Yes.
Come on, y'all.
Yes, mother.
He said, because my name won't be polluted.
Because
let me help you with something. Do y'all remember that when Elijah went to Mount Carmel, and it was the prophets of Baal against the prophet of God?
He said the prophets.
Of Baal.
Ooh, that was good. Okay.
Was coming against the prophet of God.
That was good. Okay.
And the prophet Elijah said at Mount Carmel, watch this. Watch this, y'all.
Okay.
The God that answer by fire. So now what is he saying? He said, y'all serving a God, and I'm serving the God. Which means y'all got a God that y'all think gonna do something.
Jesus!
And I got a God that I know gonna do something. So you gotta understand, y'all cry out to y'all God, and maybe y'all God will do something. And then when y'all get done crying out, I'm going to cry out to the God. Are y'all getting this? Yes, my God from Zion.
Yes,
so there's other gods out there because people believe that oranges will deliver. Y'all not said.
Mother,
people believe that big belly fat man that sit on the counter and put an orange on him. Don't do it. Some people believe that a statue of an elephant that sits in their house is going to do it. Y'all not saying nothing. Some people believe that a little box with a little piece of paper, amen, that's going to do it. That's considered their gods. Is anybody listening? That's considered their gods. And when people go to their gods, they're saying, I'm going because I need you to what? To do something. And so we have the Almighty God.
Right.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
So the battle is against what? Gods.
Come on, Mother.
Is anybody listening? So when the prophet said, y'all call on y'all God, and I'm going to call on the God, and whichever God answers, that's the one we going to serve. Is anybody listening? So that's why Isaiah came into play, Isaiah 48, and said, for my own sake. Because my name ain't finna be polluted. Because all these other people believing that these other gods, that these doctors and God and I don't have nothing. God and myself ain't got nothing against the doctors because he put everybody in earth as he see fit. But you can't put your trust in the doctor.
Come on, Mother.
But God can use the doctor. But it's the Almighty God that worketh through the doctor. You got to look beyond the man or the woman and look to the hills. Come on. Is it okay, all right? Are y'all okay out there?
Yes,
Lisa. Battle of the gods. You better tell it. Come on, you better tell it. The battle of the gods. Are you hearing me?
Yeah, that was good.
Y'all not saying nothing. Because some people, God is their money. Some people, God is their car.
Yes,
some people, God is their hair. Some people, God is their clothes. Some people, God is their children. Some people, God is their mate. Are y'all getting this? We got all type of little G's running around here. And saying, these little G's are the one that's going to get us out. These little G's are the ones that's going to bring us peace. These little G's is the ones that's going to heal us. And God said, all right, I'm going to have to do this. For my own sake.
Woo,
come on. Because my name is not going to be polluted.
Oh, glory.
Are you okay?
Yes, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord God.
Daughter said, I was not ready for this.
Woo,
glory to God. Head back shot. Yes. Come on here. Uh-huh. It's battle of the gods, baby. Come on here. And God said, for my own sake, I'm going to bless you. I'm choosing to bless you for my own sake because my name ain't going to be polluted. And I'm not giving my glory to another. I'm not giving my glory over to what came to hit you and to knock you out. I'm not giving my glory over to what came to kill you. I'm not giving my glory over to what came to make you upset and to be frustrated. I'm not giving my glory to another to make it look like that you couldn't make it. Y'all better say something. I'm not giving my glory to another to think that I did not call you by my name, said God. And DeVray said, case closed.
I know it.
Right. Go to Isaiah. Go to Isaiah chapter 46, just a couple chapters back. Just go to a couple chapters back. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
You better say it because
thank you, Lord. You better go ahead. And you better tell that negative situation that came in your life, your time is up. Because I told y'all the other day, case is closed. Come on here. Because you think you praising God and said, God, you going to do it. That's the name of the Lord. You putting the name of the Lord on that situation. Are you hearing me? And if God don't do it, then his name will be polluted. That's why you can praise God. That's why you can start smiling. Because God said, my name will not be polluted.
Come on here.
I will not be in the same categories with these other little gods that can't do nothing. These little guys that didn't create nothing. These little guys that did not bring nothing to pass. These little guys that did not create no trees. These little guys that did not create no birds. These little guys that did not create the heavens nor the earth. I'm not giving my name to be polluted with them.
Oh, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Y'all not saying that.
Thank you, Lord.
Isaiah 46 is where we're going. God said, because I said it. And if you want to say it like this, because I said so.
Yes.
And this is why I said so, because I'm not allowing my name to be polluted. My name is not in the same category with other things and people and places y'all put your trust in. Because he said, don't put your trust in no man. Don't put your trust in flesh. Is anybody listening?
Yes.
And if God don't do it, then the glory of what you are going through will begin to say, I told you he couldn't bring you out. I told you he couldn't do it. And here you go. Come on. Here you go standing on his word. Then here you go calling his name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Isaiah 46, I gotta go, beloved.
My God.
Are y'all okay?
Work the word.
Verse 10. Watch this. Isaiah 46 and verse 10. Scribes, go ahead and write it down. Declaring the end from the beginning. Declaring the end from the beginning. Tell your neighbor, you just in the process.
You just in the process.
But the beginning and the end was already declared what was going to happen. Ooh. Tell your neighbor, come on through.
Come on through.
And come on through with a praise.
And come on through with
a praise. And come on through with a thanksgiving.
Come on through with a thanksgiving.
Come on through and say, God, I know you're able to do it. Because you said according to Isaiah 48, you're going to do it for your own sake. You're going to do it for your own sake. You're going to do this. Because your name will not be polluted. God, if you don't do this, your name going to be polluted.
Come on, mother.
Because I've been telling people
come
about
on.
You.
Come
I've been
on.
Telling them that you.
Ho!
So, God, come if you here. Don't do it, your name going to be polluted.
Yes, Lord.
Come on here. And you said Jesus. You ain't going to share your glory with another. What? So I know you ain't going to share your glory with this sickness.
You must come on
I know
here.
You ain't going to share your glory with this depression.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
I know you're not going to show your...
Yes, God.
Come on here. Share your glory. Come on here. With divorce. Y'all not saying it. I know you're not going to share your glory. Are y'all getting this? Mm-hmm. Are y'all understanding
yes,
it?
Yes.
Because if God don't do it, that means he's sharing his glory
right.
with that negativity.
That's right. And he's not doing that.
And he said, I'm not doing that. My name will not be polluted. God said, I stand by my name. I watch over. Come on, somebody. So you better give God back his word today.
Yeah.
Come on here.
Yes.
Give God back his word. Drop the mic and keep on walking. And God will look and say, oh, look at my daughter. Oh, look at my son. I got to do this for my own sake. Are y'all hearing God?
Yes, mother.
He says, declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done. The things that are not yet done. My counsel shall stand and I will do all my pleasure. What did it say in Isaiah 48? For my what?
Own sake.
For my what?
Own
will I what? Do it. And over here he said, what? He said, I will do all my pleasure.
All my pleasures.
Go to verse 11. Calling the ravenous, dirty birds.
What you say? The
from the east, the man that executed my counsel from a far country. Yea, I have spoken it. And I will also bring it to pass. I have purposed it. And I will what? Also what? Do it. What did it say over here in Isaiah 48? For my what?
Namesake.
For my what?
Namesake.
Come on here. Will I do it? Shall we go further?
Yes.
Shall we go further?
Yes.
God said, this is my counsel. I ain't sit down with nobody.
Come on here.
I didn't even sit down with you and counsel with you about this.
Apostle, you telling the truth.
Yeah, I know me. Come on, her.
He said, I didn't even fill you in. He said, I ain't fill you in. He said, what am I about to do for you, this next move of me? I ain't fill you in on this, but I'm telling you why I'm doing it. He said, this is why I'm getting ready to do this next move for you. Because my name cannot be polluted. And I'm not sharing my glory with another. Yes, he did, Apostle. He did show me. No, boo, he didn't show you this one.
Come on here.
Come on. He didn't fill this one in to us.
Here,
he said, but I'm going to tell you why I'm going to do it. This is what I'm going to do. The next move, the next wind of blessings, the next deliverance that's getting ready to hit your house, the next breakthrough, the next opportunity, the next investments that's coming to you. This is what I'm going to do. Because if I don't do it, my name, say God, is going to be polluted.
Mother.
And I'm not sharing my glory with another. I'm not sharing that. Y'all. Are y'all getting this?
Oh, yes.
Are y'all understanding this?
Yes.
Y'all know how I am about being on my bus now.
Come on, mother.
Y'all know how I am about being on my bus.
Yes.
If you got on my bus, my charter bus, if you got on my yacht, glory to God, ride with me.
Come on here.
Now, if you came on this channel, you got on my bus, you got on my yacht, now follow.
Okay.
Come on, somebody. He told me to tell somebody. All is clear now. All is clear now. Y'all not saying nothing. All is clear. The storm has already passed over. And what you will see will be the residue. The storm is still, it's not there. It's just residue. He said, I'm going to do my good pleasure. I did not counsel with you. I didn't sit down with you, even though I love you. And I tell you everything, but I didn't tell you this. And please don't tell me God tells us everything. Because the prophet said, God, you hid this from me. You didn't even tell me that she was going through. You didn't even tell me. So don't come talk about God tells you everything. Because God don't tell us everything. There's just some things, glory to God, he keeps to himself and then he blows our mind. Is anybody listening?
Yes, Mother, I'm listening.
Or did everybody go home?
Yes,
glory to God. Glory to God. Go to Joshua 21. Go to Joshua 21. Are y'all okay out there?
Yes,
he said, for my own sake. Boo, we could stop it right now. We could shut the tape down right now. Because Isaiah 48 just slapped us 50 times.
Yes,
and then Isaiah 46 come back and said, I counsel with myself. I ain't counsel with nobody. And I'm doing my pleasure. I'm going to do this. Amen. Thank you, Sally. Sally said, I've been riding this bus for a year.
Okay.
I need a greeter right there. She said, I've been riding this bus for a year. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Ooh, that was good right there, Sally. I needed a greeter right there. My God, from Zion, she came back and said, I've been riding this bus for a year. Joshua 21. Are y'all ready?
Yes, Mother.
Joshua 21 and verse 45. Here we go. Watch this. There failed not. There failed not. There failed not aught of any good thing which the Lord has spoken unto the house of Israel. All came to pass. Everything God speaks is coming to pass. Because I said God. It got to come to pass.
Got to come to pass.
Because I said it got to come to pass. And Joshua backs him up. There failed not aught, watch this, of any good thing which the Lord had spoken unto the house of Israel. We are the spiritual house of Israel. And God said, not one of my words that I've spoken regarding you is going to fall to the ground. I told you earlier, you can take this to the bank and you can cash it because you're going to get, amen, a refund. You're going to get, amen, an exchange. Something is going to happen. Tell your neighbor, it's on up in here.
It's on up in here, Minister.
Are y'all listening?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes.
That's Joshua 21
cash it, mother, cash
and verse 45.
Yes, come on,
this is Joshua getting ready to go off scene. And he telling the people everything God said to us.
Everything God spoke.
Watch this. Watch what he said. Everything he spoke, because everything God speak is what? Good.
Come on.
Because in Genesis, it says, and let there be light, and there was light, and God said the light was what? Good. So everything God speak is what? Good.
Come on,
So he said, who is he? Joshua, as he's going off scene, said, let me help y'all with something. Let me help you to remember that everything God said and everything he said was good. It all came to pass. Nothing failed.
Come on now, mother.
So you could take this to the bank. You can write this down on your calendar. And if you even want to, and said God spoke it through, amen, the clay lips of Apostle or Dr. Jackson, however you want to put it. But I'm telling you now, the word that God brought to us on today is not going to fall to the ground. Is anybody listening?
Yes,
you better learn how to run and ride this word. Some of y'all that don't know how to ride a horse, you're going to be all right. Amen. To you all that know how to ride the horse, ride this word. Come on here. Glory to God. If you know how to ride a bike, ride this word. Come on here. If you know how to surf, ride this word. Is anybody listening? My God, everything God said is good. This what got me. This is what keep playing in my spirit. He said, I'm not giving my glory to another. Right there, lets me know God not finna share and say I was in with that because I wasn't in with that. That is not my manifestation. That's not my promise. That's not my blessing. That I said that I was going to give or do unto you or for you.
Come on here, mother.
Oh, I got to go.
Come on.
I got to go.
You ain't my God.
They told me I don't have to go.
You don't have to go, mother.
Oh, we got to take the church.
Genesis 26. Let's go. They told me you ain't got to go. That's the old way. Wait a minute. Yes, we do. We got to get the kids to Genesis 26.
Hey, God,
Genesis chapter 26. Genesis chapter 26. And go to verse 24. Genesis chapter 26 and verse 24. We're going to hit 28 and verse 29 to the scribes that is writing. Write down Genesis 26, 24, 28, and 29. The Bible decrees the word of God to be so. And the Lord appeared unto him the same night. And the Lord appeared unto you today. He's going to appear to you today. And the Lord appeared unto him the same night and said, I am the God of Abraham, the father. Fear not, for I am with thee, and I will bless thee, and then multiply thy seed for my servant Abraham's sake. Over there in Isaiah, he said, I'm going to do it for what? My own sake. Now he said, I'm going to do it for what? Abraham's sake. Oh, God, I love you.
Father!
Jesus. Verse 28. And they said, we saw certainly that the Lord was with thee. And we said, let there be now an oath betwixt us, even betwixt us and thee. And let us make a covenant with thee. Because we see that God is with you. We saw that you was going through. But we see God with you. How can you see that God is with a person? Because God has manifested his glory. His glory is in the blessing. His glory is in the healing. His glory is in the deliverance. His glory is in the breakthrough. Are y'all getting it?
Yes, mother. Yes.
Well, I tell you to go. Verse 28. And they said, we saw certainly the Lord was with thee. Okay. Go to verse 29. That thou would do us no hurt as we have not touched thee. And as we have done unto thee nothing but good.
Nothing.
And have sent thee away in peace. Thou art now the blessed of the Lord.
Come on.
This is Isaac. And Isaac was digging the wells. And because Isaac was digging the well, fights and different things kept coming up against.
Yeah.
But there came a time when Isaac dug this last well.
No!
And it was called Rehoboth. God made room for us. And the Bible said that here it is, those that saw and know that Isaac was going through, they now realize that God was with Isaac. Then they turn around and tell him, you are now blessed of the Lord. How can they say that? Not because Isaac was just saying out of his mouth. It is because they saw the manifestation of what God said. Y'all not saying nothing. So when you see the glory of God, it is going to be the manifestation of what God spoke that he said. Because I said it, I got to now give them the glory. And to give one the glory is the manifestation of a thing. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
and they begin to say in verse 29, and I'm doing what? Glory to God. They said, you are blessed of the Lord. Come on. Don't do us no hurt. We saw you going through. We saw it with our own eyes. But we also saw the hand of God. We also saw your God bring you into a wealthy place. And then they begin to declare a word to Isaac and said, you are blessed. You are now blessed of the Lord. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? Tell your neighbor, prophesy to your neighbor, and you know how we do it. If you don't have a neighbor, you are your neighbor, and say to your neighbor, you are now blessed of the Lord.
You are now blessed of the Lord, minister. Come on, work.
And if you're now blessed of the Lord, then God is about to manifest, watch this, his glory.
Come on, mother.
Because that we are going through that is negative is not the glory of God.
Yes.
Is anybody listening? That's not the glory of God. That's not what God spoke. That's not what God said. Are you hearing what the Lord is saying? He said, I'm not sharing my glory with that. And my name will not be polluted as if I put my name, a stamp of approval, on that negative. Are y'all listening?
Yes, mother.
Are y'all understanding?
Yes.
That's why you got to praise God. That's why you got to tell your body, God ain't sharing no glory
God
with this.
Ain't no
God,
glory.
God ain't sharing no glory. God ain't getting the glory out of you being sick. God ain't getting the glory, glory to God, out of you ain't got no money. God ain't getting the glory out of this.
How? You
best
come on here. Yes, Lord. He
ain't
getting the glory out of that right there.
As I turn the radio, volume down now because I gotta go. My time is up, but I got a lot of more words. As I close, I'm closing with this, John 15 and verse 16. The Bible decrees and says it like this: you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, ordained you that you should go and bring forth not no foul fruit, but you shall bring forth fruit, and that your fruit shall remain.
Yes!
That whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, I will not allow my name to be polluted. He may give it to you. The Lord said, you ain't choose me. I chose you. And I chose you and ordained you to bring fruit, good fruit, and for your fruit to remain.
Oh God.
That whatsoever you ask in my name, ask the Father in my name, I'm going to what? Give it to you. And the Father says in Isaiah, I got to do this for my own sake. For my own sake. Will I do it? For my name will not be polluted, and I will not share my glory with another. So, beloved, you got to understand, we didn't choose God. God chose us. Come on here. And he chose us. He has ordained us to bring fruit, good fruit, and the fruit is supposed to remain. Now, if fruit is supposed to remain, then why does it keep leaving? The fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit is what? Peace, love, joy, long-suffering, faith, meekness. Are you getting this? Temperance. Are you hearing me? And it is supposed to do what? Remain. Watch this. So if peace is not there, then frustration is there. Are y'all getting this? See, it has to remain. And so God said, for my own sake, for my own sake, will I do it? Because my name is not going to be polluted. And I'm not giving my glory to this situation you're going through. I'm going to bring you out. Genesis says that God said, you came into the place called Rehoboth, that I made room for you. And now you are blessed of the Lord, for this is the word of God concerning your life on January the 31st, 2018. Now what you do with it is on you, boo. because I've delivered the message. Are you hearing me? So you go and you take this word. And if I was you, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to run with this word. I'm going to tell the negative situation that God is not going to let this go down like this. Because if he do, then his name, come on here, his name is being shared with this. And he said he's not going to share his name nor his glory. Well, beloved, we thank God for you, 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 and you. This is the word of the Lord. And this is the Weather Forecast Channel. And I am your Weather Forecast announcer. If you would like to sow a seed upon the atmosphere of this word, because there's an atmosphere that has been conducive for things to happen. Because remember now, the weather forecast is to tell what is happening in the atmosphere of the realm of the spirit. And this is what's happening for you, 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 and you, and myself, according to the word of God. And so if this day is the day that you would like to sow a seed, do not use that old email address that is no longer alive. That case has been closed. But now you can use the new one. You go to PayPal and you can sow your best seed on today according to the atmosphere that was delivered from the word. Hey, are you hearing me? And when you go, follow the promptings, the links, and also then begin to type in Vanessa Jackson 03. Write this down, Sister Regina. I think you went off. Vanessa Jackson 0310 at gmail.com. Let me say it again. You could go to PayPal and you could sow your seed. But this time, don't go to the old email because that no longer exists. That case has been closed. But the new one is Vanessa Jackson 0310 at gmail.com. If you want to sow your seed by mail, you can sow it by mailing it to 3727 SICILY Street. That's Irving, Texas, 75038. However you want to sow, sow today. The word of the Lord has been spoken. So you be blessed. This is the time that God is getting ready to do great things. And you don't have to explain about the next move of God. You don't have to tell nobody. They'll see what God has purposed and planned. Watch this. And decided for you. Well, we pray for everybody, God, everyone that came on this morning. I pray that you cover them in the blood. I pray, Father God, that the word of God, amen, will fall on good ground in their spirit, oh God, and that it will begin to bring forth 100-fold. 60-fold. So, Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you stirred up our spirits on today and that you caused us to come into that place in the realm of the spirit where you have been calling us to. We thank you, Father God, that those that have even prayer requests that is on here, that you have answered their prayers through this word. And so, Father, I pray now that you begin to touch every mind, every spirit, every heart, and every soul. I pray, Father God, that you will cover them and those that will go this day throughout the day. I pray for traveling grace and traveling mercy. I pray now, God, that you will release your angels and that your angels will assist them in bringing this word to pass. Father, I thank you for what you have done in our life. As we close out, amen, January 2018, we decree and declare that the rest of our year is going to be so awesome because you said it. And so, Father God, bless the works of our hands. Bless us, God, to walk upright before you because you said in your word, you will hold no good thing from us. God, I thank you for my sister. I thank you for my brother in Zion. I pray, Father God, the prayer requests, the petitions that they have up before you, Father God, that you will begin to answer. I pray, Father God, before the week is out, you blow their mind to let them know that they stopped by the Weather Forecast Channel because you unctioned them too, because it was a divine appointment for them to hear what thus said the Lord. God, we give you back your glory by giving you praise in advance. We thank you, Lord God, that our name is ever before you. We thank you, Lord God, that our names are imprinted in the palm of your hands. We thank you, Lord God, that you have not forgotten about us. We thank you, Lord God, that you are doing just what you said you're going to do. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are, glory to God, in our life and you're causing us to do what we need to do. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you're bringing us and showing us what we need to do. Father, we bless you today. Bless, bless as we leave, glory to God, this Facebook channel, but not your presence. Until next time, beloved, you go with God, and God, he'll go with you. Please don't forget, if you want to sow your seed, they wrote it down, amen, on the screen of where you can sow. And to you, don't forget, this is the last day of January. You give your first fruits. Find your man, find your woman of God, and release that first fruit. And if you're not connected or linked to a ministry or church, go ahead and sow your first fruit. Until next time, let's pray for one another. Let's encourage one another. Let's keep, amen, keep our names up. Amen to God. Are you hearing me? I love you. Until next time, may the blessings of the Lord make you rich and it add no sorrow. I feel the power and the presence of God. Somebody is getting blessed right now. Until next time, blessings.